Flint, Michigan Brass Band Autumn Concert for 2022 here at Bullet Creek High School Auditorium. I'm Art Ferruzzi, and I would like to start by explaining why this afternoon's concert will not follow our normal format. On November 19th, we will be competing in the annual U.S. Open Brass Band Championships at the Clarkston Performing Arts Center. The U.S. Open is an annual one-day invitational contest for traditional bands from around the nation and the world. The goal of the U.S. Open is to encourage the further growth and development of the brass band movement in North America. The contest's format focuses on entertainment, which is unique among brass band contests in North America. No test piece is required. Instead, each band will perform a 25-minute set of music of their choosing. And this is where the alteration to our normal concert format comes in. The first half of our concert this afternoon covers the five pieces we are preparing for the U.S. Open, and it will be timed as if we were at the competition. This means that I have to stick to a specific script, at least until after intermission. Now, without further ado, I want to introduce a performing member of the Mid-Michigan Brass Band since 2015, a performer in various other musical ensembles, including the East Shore Wind Symphony, the Fröhliche Musiker Blastorchester, the Bay Concert Band, and the Classic Legacy Band of Saginaw. And on top of it all, she's also a participating member on the board of directors for the Leonard Falcone International Euphonium and Tuba Festival. Please join me in welcoming to the stage our guest conductor, Cian Pfeiffer. Hello, my name is Art Ferruzzi, and this is the Mid-Michigan Brass Band. The band is thrilled to take you on an African adventure this morning. We open our program with Christopher Warmall's arrangement of Africa by Toto. I bless the rains down in Africa. Thank you. We now take you to the Sahara, where the African lionesses hunt their prey. You'll hear the lioness chase the impala until she has finally caught it, very proud of the kill, until the herd starts to move and the hunt starts again. Sit back and enjoy the chase, as depicted in African Odyssey, Movement 3, Sahara, by Richard Grantham.
Thank you.
We continue the program with Elephant Patrol by Philip Harper. You will hear the elephants coming from the distance in typical patrol fashion until they are right in front of you in full force. Then, as they pass by, you'll continue to hear them as they pass into the distance. Thank you. No African adventure would be complete without a tribute to Nelson Mandela, the man who helped end apartheid. Hymn for Africa was inspired by the release of Nelson Mandela in the early 1990s and the effect it had upon not only South Africa, but over the entire continent. We hope you enjoy Peter Mishan's Hymn for Africa.
Thank you.
Before we end our program today, the Mid-Michigan Brass Band would like to thank the Brass Band U.S. Open, its organizers and sponsors. We finish our program with our rendition of African Odyssey Movement 5, Finale, where the animals live in harmony and you may even hear a stray elephant. We hope you enjoyed our African adventure, and we hope to see you again next year. To start out the second half of our spring concert, we begin with Alan Ferney's arrangement of the Beatles' 1965 number one hit, Ticket to Ride. The song was written by John Lennon and credited to both Lennon and Paul McCartney. Now, John and Paul were known to disagree on occasion, and in a 1980 interview, Lennon said that McCartney's contribution was limited to the way Ringo played the drums on the recording. However, in his 1997 biography, McCartney is quoted as saying, "We sat down and wrote it together. Give him 60% of it." The lyrics of Ticket to Ride describe a girl riding out of the life of the narrator. However, the inspiration for the title phrase is unclear, as the meaning of the song is as well. McCartney said the title referred to a British Railways ticket to the town of Ryde on the Isle of Wight, while Lennon said it described cards indicating a clean bill of health carried by Hamburg prostitutes in the 1960s. In any case, we're not singing this afternoon, so you'll have to just look it up online or listen to it on Spotify and figure it out for yourselves. Our next piece features soloist Wes Ahrens, in Stefan Schwalgen's arrangement of Feeling Good from the 1964 British musical The Roar of the Grease Paint, The Smell of the Crowd. Wes has been playing trombone since 2008, and while studying acoustical engineering at Purdue University, he managed to find time to perform with the Purdue Wind Ensemble as well as the Boiler Brass. Prior to his time at Purdue, Wesley marched with two seasons of Drum Corps International with the Blue Stars Drum and Bugle Corps of La Crosse, Wisconsin. He's also had the privilege of performing in some places that you might have heard of, such as Carnegie Hall, Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade, and the Rose Parade, to name a few. Please join me in welcoming to the stage our featured soloist, Wes Ahrens.
Thank you.
The second suite in F major, also known as a second suite in F for military band, Opus 28, number 2, is Gustav Holst's second and last suite for concert band and has become a staple of the band repertoire. This suite has four moments, the first three of which are based on folk songs. However, the fourth is based instead on two tunes from an English dancing manual from 1651, surprisingly titled The English Dancing Master. We hope you enjoy Sidney Herbert's brass band arrangement of Gustav Holst's second suite in F major. Thank you. Born to Italian immigrants in Hoboken, New Jersey, Frank Sinatra was one of the most popular American entertainers of the mid-20th century. He was famously known as the chairman of the board. Some have attributed this nickname to his popularity, or his huge career in both music and movies, or perhaps his leadership of the 1960s version of the Rat Pack, which included other A-listers, who appeared together in Las Vegas casinos and this would be Dean Martin, Sammy Davis Jr., Peter Lawford, and Joy Bishop. It turns out that he was actually the chairman of the board of Reprise Records, a company he founded as his own record label because he wanted more creative freedom. Please enjoy a tribute to Frank Sinatra, arranged for brass band by Rijks van der Velde.
Thank you.
Before we get to our final selection this evening, we want to thank each and every one of you for joining us tonight. Bullet Creek Schools and Jason Tisdale for providing us with this wonderful venue. The Midland Community Television Network for our concert production. Ken Bellin for our concert recording. And Ann Leonard, our outstanding librarian. Also, I'd like to call out Matt and Beth Ann Thomas for spending their 18th wedding anniversary with the Mid-Michigan Brass Band, ensuring that the music is available on TV. We need to also thank some very important people, our contributors, including the Rollin M. Gerstacker Foundation, the Alden and Veda Dow Foundation, the J.H. Walker Foundation, Mr. John Leiprent, and Bricks Real Estate Experts. If you've enjoyed tonight's concert, please consider a donation to our band so we can continue to perform for you. Donation boxes are located near the exits. Just two more things to say before I get to the final number. Please note that our Christmas concert this year will be held on December 11th at the Meridian Early College High School Auditorium. And finally, details on the location of our concerts are also communicated on our Facebook page and on our website at www.midmichiganbrassband.com. Our final number was composed by Saginaw native Stevland Hardaway Judkins. You all probably know him as Stevie Wonder. He didn't spend much time in Saginaw, moving to Detroit when he was only 4, where he sang as a child at the Whitestone Baptist Church and began playing instruments at an early age, including piano, harmonica, and drums. He formed a singing partnership with a friend, calling themselves Stevie and John. They played on street corners and occasionally at parties and dances. In 1961, at the age of 11, Wonder sang his own composition, Lonely Boy, to Ronnie White of the Miracles, who then took Wonder to Motown Records to meet CEO Berry Gordy. Wonder was quickly signed to Motown's Tamla label, and his first album titled The Jazz Soul of Little Stevie was released in 1962. I'm not going to cover the rest of Stevie Wonder's amazing career here, but I highly recommend looking it up. So, for closing this afternoon's concert, we will perform Jeff Richards' brass band arrangement of Stevie Wonder's Sir Duke. Wonder wrote Sir Duke as a tribute to Duke Ellington, the jazz composer, band leader, and pianist who had influenced him as a musician. Please drive home safely and enjoy the rest of your evening.